Drew the Entertainer with Serpent City Exotics. I'm going to be making a video on how I set up my own boa tank. I know some of you are wondering, why is your boa tank so bare bone like this? Well, in one of my last videos that I did of my albino boa shedding, I swore, one of the viewers said I had mite. It looked like a mite. It moved like a mite. I stripped this thing bare ass, cleaned it, sanitized it, hosed it down with ice cold water, inspected all of my snakes, head to toe, well, more like head to tail, and I did not see anything at all on them. I soaked every single thing on here in cold ass water for 3 days. The bark background I had, it's in my freezer. I put it in there for about 72 hours, just in case if anything was in there, they're dead, you know, because it was natural bark background. So I put it in my freezer for 72 hours. So I'm sure if anything was on there, it's dead. So as far as I know, my boas are in 100% healthy condition. So all right, let me start off by show you how I put the bedding on, what kind of bedding, and how do I go about putting it in, and what kind of bedding I use. So stand by and check it out. All right, this is the bedding that I use. It's Eco Earth by Zoomed. I find this bedding extremely great when it comes to providing humidity to your reptile. I use it for my pythons, you know, my boas, obviously, and I find it great, especially when they defecate. It really dulls the smell down a little bit because those boas take monster dumps. So I like to buy the brick bedding. I used to buy the bagged, but I find it safer to use the brick. Reason being, because you could put it in water and let it stay there for about 30 minutes. And say if there was mites in here, they'll be dead. Because I put it in hot water and I leave it for about a half an hour to 45 minutes in there. And it's also cheaper. It's, for three bricks, it's about, where is it, $7.99, it's right there, $7.99, not bad at all. So I'll take one of the bricks, or probably two of the bricks, let me put on the floor here. Take two of the bricks. It's hard to do this in one hand, but I'm trying. See this right here? I know some of you guys are thinking, well, it's small, it's not going to really work for me. I'm telling you right now, this little brick right here tripled its size after 30 minutes. It's crazy. It's like freaking magic. You put it in there, in a pail or a bucket or whatever, of a warm water or hot water. Wait 30 minutes to 45 minutes, and it triples its size. It's crazy. So I put it in here, regular bucket. I put it with hot water. I put this brick inside, Eco Earth brick, just like that. Leave it there for about, you know, 30 minutes, 45 minutes, like I said. I'm actually going to put two in there because I have a pretty large tank. And I just put it in here, the hot water. Thanks to me, it's the safest way. And, yeah, and leave it in there. Yeah, and in 30 minutes it'll triple its size, and that pail will be full of dirt. And I'll show you guys how I put it in and everything like that. So this is how I do my substrate. Every time I do my substrate, this is how I do it. Eco Earth, brick size, put in water, safest way. Definitely suggested for almost any kind of snakes, ball pythons, reticulated pythons, boas, whatever. Extremely great substrate. I really like it. I've tried cypress mulch. I've tried aspen. You know, I just find those not too good holding humidity. Aspen's more like straw or hay. You know, it's good for like corn snakes or whatever like that. But I just find this just holds so much humidity so much better. So highly suggested. All right, now to move on to my my background. All right, YouTube, as you can see, it is now 100% eco earth. Those two little bricks filled up this bucket. It's a pretty decent sized bucket, more than halfway. As you can see, eco earth. It's been about a half an hour, 35 minutes, and 100% eco earth. You know, simple, cheap, safe, highly recommended. Eco earth, I really, really recommend it a lot. Holds the humidity just great. So before I put that in, I'm going to show you how I put my background in, because I bought a new bark background from the Reptile Expo not too long ago, and I have it in the freezer that I left in there for 72 hours, so we're going to check that out. Alright, here is the bark background that I put, and I left it in here in the freezer for 72 hours. See all my meats and shit. But, yep, it's right here. I put them in bags. Anything that was in here, if there was any mites or whatever, totally dead. They ain't surviving 72 hours of freezing, you know, freezing environment like that. So here it is. Let me open it. Stand by, guys. Sorry about the wait. This right here. There we go. It's my natural bark background from the ZooMed. Makes the enclosures look really, really good. It really brings out the natural naturalness of the whole environment. I thought it was really cool. And how I went to go put this on, one of my subscribers told me to make a video on how I place this. Well, I put industrial strength, what is this stuff called? Can't even think. Industrial strength Velcro from Home Depot. I put it on the bottom and also on the top. As you can see in my tank, I have it on the top and I have it on the bottom to double secure it. Because sometimes it'll come loose, but if you have it double secured with the industrial strength of this stuff, man, it is great. Great, great, great to have, and it's not going to budge. So I did it for all of my bark background pieces. As you can see here, well, one's missing over there. Bark background, have it in there. I place it in between there. And I put this in before I put the bedding in, so it can be nice, tightly, and secured, and you won't have any residue all around here and stuff like that. So it won't, the Velcro could really stick on really well. So I'm going to show you how I do that in a second. All right, before I put the background in, I'm going to, before I attempt to put the background in, I'm going to take my boas out and I'm going to put it in a bin. So, because they're going to be all up in this tank and I don't want to disturb them, stress them out or whatever. So I'm going to take my motley boa right here. I'm going to make another video of my boas. Probably in another couple weeks, because I haven't done an update on these guys yet in a while. Last time I did an update was when I was taping with my cell phone. Look at this girl, man. She's such an active girl, man. These boas do not stay still at all. So, yeah. It's my big boy. My favorite out of the three. Beautiful albino. And the infamous Sun Glow Boa. I'm definitely gonna do catch up on this guy. As you can see, let me see if it come on focus. Focus. I'm trying to focus because it has so much coral and pink on her, man. It's on him. It's insane. You can see that. Flushed in coral. He is a beauty. Come on. There you go. Now you can see the flush of coral and pink on this big boy right here. See that? Gorgeous. All that coral and pink is just all over him. I'll definitely do a catch-up video with some natural lighting. You know, when it gets warm outside up in New York, I'm going to definitely take him outside. He just finished eating a medium-sized rat not too long ago. Put him in here. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful boas. Big, huge boa fan right here. Put him in here for a little bit. Clip him down. And I'm going to put the backgrounds in. So stand by. All right, here's the realistic bark background. Add the stuff in the back to stick on, right here, the Velcro. I don't know why I keep forgetting that word. But you put it back here, one on the bottom right here, one on the top. Just hook it up, nice and tight. Make sure it's nice and secure on the top as well as the bottom. And it's coming together. I take one down here again, take it, put it right next to it, line it flush so it could look like one piece. You know, you don't want it to look too separated and look stupid. So this stuff is really, really sticky. You know, so make it nice and flush, make it look like one piece, make it look more natural. So as you can see there, nice and flush. Looks like one piece, nice and neat. This is the second to last one. Also, we'll line it really good over here. Line it perfect. Switching hands here. Oh my God, this stuff is freaking sticky. Bottom. You gotta make sure it's secure on the bottom and the top. You don't want the bottom to be more secure than the top and this top more secure than the bottom. You just want it to be even so it won't come out and look stupid or fall on your snakes. Alright, the last one's going in. It's right here. And we have one up top. I guess it came off or whatever, but we'll worry about that another day. Alright. This stuff is fucking really crazy. Alright. It's on there. Really, really good. Alright. And that is the background to my boa enclosure. Now I'm going to attempt to put the bedding in, the EcoEarth bedding, which is right here. So stand by. All right, so I finished putting the bedding in my boa's enclosure. Took a little bit because it's a decently sized tank, but you could just see it's just so perfect. It's moist, not too moist where they're gonna get scale rot, but moist enough to keep the humidity in the tank at a decent level. Because that being a glass tank, it doesn't hold that good of humidity. But with this bedding, it really holds its humidity really, really well. Nice, clean water bowl. Relatively large. I may need a bigger water bowl in a couple weeks, actually. So I'm definitely going to invest in that. But, yeah, EcoEarth bedding. Great. Mite-free. I'm going to add some little decorations here. I got silk leaves right here. I'm going to put in the corners. As you can see, that little gap there, I didn't feel like cutting a little piece of wood, so I'll put the silk leaf right there. It'll cover up really well, and you won't even notice that gap where the natural bark wasn't reaching. I like to put it on both sides of the tank. Get that, you know, that rainforest look or whatever. You can get these at Petco, PetSmart, or any really good reptile spot. Make it look real nice and natural. You know, it brings it out a little bit. I was putting hides in here, like hollow log hides, plastic, not natural. But it worked when the boas were like, you know, 6 months. But now, some of them is almost big as me, and those little hides are just not working out anymore. So I come to the reality there's gonna be no more hides. It's gonna be just like this. I got the screen top, nice big old screen top to go on top of here. I got hides in there that will look really good in there, but it's not realistic anymore. They just can't be inside a hide anymore. They're just too big. So this is a basic reptile enclosure. I got the dual lamps right here that I put on top of here. Got the night and the day bulb, 100 watts, and leave it on there for 12 hours of light, 12 hours of night, and they love it, and they're going to love it. So this is the basic setup of my reptile enclosure for my boa constrictors. If any of you guys have any questions or comments or whatever, feel free. I'll answer what I can, and if I can't answer and I don't know the answer, I'll definitely find out, and I'll definitely inbox you, or I'll leave a comment below. So this is Drew the Entertainer with Serpent City Exotics. Thank you guys for watching. As you can see, the background looks great, looks flush, looks nice, looks realistic. The leaves really give it like a rainforest look. The rock bowl, the rock water bowl, really makes it look good as well. It's not those like dog bowls that just throw the whole thing off. I want to get the whole theme of like a rainforest look. And the Igor's bedding definitely makes it look good as well. I'm going to put this light on so you can see it better. There you go. Alright. And it even looks much, much better with the snakes in the enclosure. So I'm definitely going to be taping that. But yeah, silk leaves definitely make a difference too. And you can put the silk leaves anywhere. And you can put two on that side, one on this side, or two on that side and two on this side. You can do whatever you want. You know, these hookup enclosures are really, really nice to just customize yourself. And sometimes I like to move my stuff around to make it look better. Like I might put like bark backgrounds on the sides or whatever. We'll see. But I feel like there's no vines needed. You know, these boas are big. They're just going to run over those vines and flatten them out. So there's definitely no need for any vines or any hides. You know, these are not ball pythons. You know, they're pretty thick bodied, long snakes. So if you have any questions, please ask Drew the Entertainer, Serpent City Exotics. Rate, comment, subscribe, and share this video if you want. I'm going to put this on my reptile Facebook page under Serpent City, the city with an S. So you could find me and friend me on Facebook as well. I'm always on Facebook. I'm always chatting on Facebook. I'm always putting pictures and videos on Facebook. So hit me up, guys. Let me know what you guys think. All right? As always, see you later, guys. Well, I'm not going yet. I just wanted to show you guys that my snakes are happy and in their enclosures. And as you can see, it just looks really, really nice. Especially with the snakes in there, of course. It's my albino right there. Loving it. Beautiful, beautiful, great eater. One of my favorite out of the three. Here's my motley, 66% head albino from jimmysnakes.com. This is my infamous sunglow boa. One of my nicest looking boas. Beautiful flushed coral and pink all throughout its body. The owner that gave it to me, the breeder I should say it was one of the best ones out of the whole clutch because of the so much flushed out coral. Let me see if we get a nice zoom on that again. Come on, camera. There you go. Beautiful zoom. Beautiful boa. On the sides, also flushed out with pink and coral. Real jewel out of the whole clutch that he said that he had. I got them at CD Reptiles, I think. .com. It's my Motley right there. She's one strong snake. No doubt about it. She is strong. There you go. She has that patented white dot on her head for whatever reason. But my snakes are happy. They love their enclosures. They have clean sheds. They eat well. They look well. And I'm just really happy they're happy. So this is them in their enclosure. And it's Drew the Entertainer once again with Serpent City Exotics. See you later, guys. Rate, comment, subscribe, and share the video. Thanks, guys.